Hello everyone and welcome to Moonlight Jewel. My name is Elisa and today's video will be very special. A few weeks ago, one of my favorite doll artists, Mozukito, made a Harajuku-inspired Decora custom doll. And after I've talked to Catherine from Delightful on how we both absolutely adore this doll, we wanted to surprise Mozukito by collaborating and making our very own Harajuku fashion-inspired custom doll. As soon as I started searching for inspiration, I definitely wanted to make a doll inspired by the Harajuku fashion icon Haruka Kurebayashi. I adore her beauty and her absolute unique hairstyle, so she was the perfect inspiration for me. The beautiful candidate for this repaint was the epic winter Ever After High Apple White doll. I bought her about almost 2 years ago and it was definitely about time to customize her. It's the first time I will be repainting an Ever After High doll and I was super excited about it. But first things first, we need to remove her factory makeup with pure acetone and cut off her factory hair. Her head using boiling water and get rid of all of the stubbles inside of her head. I created a cute pattern on the back of her head to imitate the colorful undercuts Kurebayashi wears and painted her scalp in the matching colors to the hair colors she's going to get. Then I'm starting to root her bangs and ponytails by using raspberry smoothie nylon hair and monofibre hair in the colors Hollylock, Petunia and Ice Princess, all by RetroDollsUS. Then I tamed down her hair with some boiling water. After that was done, it's time for some flocking fun. To imitate the undercuts of Kurebayashi, I'm using flock and glitter on the back of her head. I simply brush on some mud podge, sprinkle on the flock, shake off the excess and repeat the steps for more opacity if necessary. I've added around 2 to 3 layers of flock for each color. Thank you. For the stars and the purple hearts, I'm adding glitter instead of flock the same way. Her hair is done and looks so sweet already. Now we can begin with her face up. After packing her hair in an old piece of fabric and spraying her 3 times with Mr. Superclear, I began adding some blushing and started sketching out the eye shape. I'm spraying her again in between whenever I'm satisfied with the progress. To add a bit of uniqueness, I'm adding some cute shapes around her eyes inspired by Caramel Laws Blythe dolls, who are absolutely amazing. For this, I'm using acrylics and pastel colors. Thank you. Then I'm adding more and more details to her face, like lashes and darker colors, and for some extra glow, she's getting some sprinkled glitter on her iris. So sparkly. I'm finishing her up with glossing her lips and giving her some pearly shimmers. Awesome! Her face is done! To style her hair, I'm simply cutting her bangs and tie her ponytails together. Onto her outfit. This time I didn't really make any kind of concept. I was just looking around what kind of fabrics I still had in my fabric box and just made some rough sketches for her outfit. Then I started by making her skirt first. I made the first layer of the skirt by using the mint white striped fabric I also used on Charlotte, the doll I made for Delightful, and then I added some pink polka dot fabric as second layer. For the third layer, I'm taking a sheet of a clear punched pocket, sew all the seams except for one and fill it with glitter. The last layer is some hot pink shiny PU leather. I gathered all of them together and add a waistband, a tiny golden 8 nib, and a snap button on the back. For a shirt, I'm layering a watermelon printed fabric with some glittering pink tulle and add some cute short sleeves, sew her into the shirt and add a sailor color made of the hot pink vinyl to the neckline. I finish it up by making a tiny clear ribbon filled with glitter and add a little heart-shaped rhinestone. To make the ribbon, I just sew two layers of clear vinyl together, melt down the seams with a lighter, fill it with glitter, close it, gather it in the middle, and glue a tiny satin ribbon around it. Next thing we are making is her jacket. I had this pink teddy fur left from my last year's Easter custom doll and decided to make a hoodie jacket. To add some cuteness, I'm cutting some white triangle out of felt, sew them on the seam of the hood, add a colored lining, turn it inside out, sew the hood onto the jacket and add some black half beads. There we go, a little monster hoodie jacket. Her outfit is done so far, so now onto the biggest challenge for this custom doll, her shoes. I wanted to make some platform sneakers with a clear glitter-filled sole, so I started by using Watercolor's papier-mâché technique to create a base for the shoe. Then I'm adding some polymer clay to the toe cap, creating a cute round shape. I bake it for about 10 minutes. Then I'm creating some soles, but try to not attach them permanently to the rest of the shoe. I bake that for 10 minutes again, separate the soles from the shoe base and bake them again for about 10 minutes. Then I'm sanding down any uneven spaces and gloss them with gloss varnish. To cast them in clear resin, I'm making a silicone mold by using Lego as a mold box and a bit of clay for the bottom. I put the soles in and mixed my silicone. Then I poured it into the mold and let it cure overnight. The next day, my mold is completely cured and I can remove the silicone and the sole bases. Now I'm mixing my clear resin. I had no idea how incredibly smelly resin is. Luckily, I had a mask, so I didn't feel dizzy while working with it. I mixed some glitter into the resin and poured it into the mold. I'm adding some extras into the mold and let it cure until the next day. On the next day, it's finally time to unmold them. Wow, they came out quite well for my first try. Yay! I'm just sanding them again with a nail buffer and gloss them with some UV gloss varnish and cure them under my UV lamp. Wow, the soles are done. Now we just have to make the rest of the shoe. The first thing I'm making are the tongues. I'm cutting out a tongue-shaped piece from the striped fabric, glue down the seams, and glue them onto the shoe base. For the toe cap of the shoe, I'm using some of the hot pink vinyl fabric. I just glue down one seam and glue it onto the cap. The fabric is a bit elastic, so I can gently pull it in place and try to reduce most of the wrinkles. Then I'm making the side parts of the shoe, which include the lacing. For that, I'm layering a striped fabric with tiny glitter-filled pockets I made and add some tiny golden eyelets I got off of eBay. Then I'm gluing the side pieces onto the shoe base. For the heel area, I'm sewing pink PU leather pieces together, glue down the seams and add a bit of interfacing for a clear finish and simply glue them onto the shoe base. I've tried out the lacing already and since it worked, I can finally glue the shoe base onto the clear resin soles. Wow, the shoes are finally done. I've worked on them for about 3 days and I'm incredibly happy how they turned out. But we're still not done yet. She needs a cute handbag too. I wanted to give her a heart-shaped handbag, so I made a little heart I used as a template, cut it out of fun foam, cut a stripe of fun foam too, and cut out the heart of 2 sheets of thin clear vinyl and 1 layer of a very thick clear vinyl. I'm covering the fun foam pieces with the teddy fur I used for the jacket as well and glued down the stripe around the heart-shaped fur piece. Then I'm taking the 2 layers of thin heart-shaped vinyl, melt down the seams with a lighter, fill it up with glitter, close the opening, layer it with a thick vinyl piece and glue that on top of the back. Covering up the edges with golden beads. I just need to add a beaded chain as a strap, and the bag is done. The last thing we need to make is the headdress. I'm taking Applewhite's earmuffs as a base and paint them teal. Then I'm taking some props I made or found in my crafting box and simply hot glued them on. To make the little accessories for her bangs, I'm taking some small sequins, put a bit of double-faced tape on them and glued them onto her bangs. Wow, we're finally done! How do you like my Harajuku doll? I'm so happy how she turned out. The cute smile of Applewhite matches the colors and the style so good in my opinion. What do you like most? Please let me know in the comments below. And don't forget to check out Delightful's video on her Harajuku doll too! And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for some future custom fun. Thank you so much for watching and have a beautiful creative day. Bye!